हेलो वेलकम अगेन, वी आर सॉल्विंग सम क्वेश्चंस ऑफ हीट ट्रांसफर। द टॉपिक इज वन डायमेंशनल कंडक्शन हीट ट्रांसफर। क्वेश्चन नंबर 12 इज ए कंपोजिट वॉल हैविंग यूनिट लेंथ नॉर्मल टू द प्लेन ऑफ पेपर इज इंसुलेटेड एट द टॉप एंड बॉटम एज शोन इन द फिगर। इट इज कंप्राइज्ड ऑफ फोर डिफरेंट मटेरियल्स ए बी सी एंड डी। सो दिस इज द वॉल A, B, C, and D. This length is L1, this length is L2, this length is L3. This height is HC, this is HB, and this is your HA or HB. And here the temperature is T1 and H1, here the temperature is T2. Okay. So dimensions are HA is equal to HD is equal to 3 meter, HB is equal to HC is equal to 1.5 meter, L1 is equal to L3 is equal to 0.05 meter, L2 is equal to 0.1 meter. Thermal conductivities of the material are Ka is equal to Kd is equal to 50 watt per meter per degree Kelvin, Kb is equal to 10 watt per meter per degree Kelvin, and Kc is equal to 1 watt per meter per degree Kelvin. The fluid properties, the fluid temperature and heat transfer coefficients are T1 is equal to 200 degrees Celsius and H1 is equal to 50 watt per meter square per degree Kelvin, T2 is equal to 21 degrees Celsius and H2 is equal to 10 watt per meter square per degree Kelvin. The rate of heat transfer through the wall is option A 4.03, option B 3.15, and option C 2.18. So this is the, these are the condition. HA and HB are equal, that is 3 meters, HB and HC are equal, that is 1.5 meter, and H1 and L3 are equal, that is 0.05 meter, and L2 is 0.1 meter. K and KB are equal 50 watt per meter per degree. KB and KC are 10 and 1. H1 is your 50 watt per meter square per degree. H2 is your 10 watt per meter square per degree. T1 is equal to 200 degrees Celsius, then T2 is equal to 25 degrees Celsius. So this is the equivalent resistance circuit, equivalent electric resistance circuit of heat flow. And first of all, there is a convective distance here, then it is 1 by H1A1, and then there is a wall A, then this is your delta XA divided by KA, and then there is a wall B and C, so that delta XB divided by KB AB, and this is delta XC KC by AC. Then there is resistance, then there is distance of wall D, that is delta XD KD by AD, and then there is a convective heat transfer resistance, so that is 1 by H1A. So we are taking it as R1, this is R2, and this equivalent distance is R3, and this is as R4, this is R5. So R1 is 1 by H1 A1, H1 is 50, and A1 is your 3 into 1, because HA is your 3. So taking one unit perpendicular to book paper, unit thickness perpendicular paper, okay. And R2 will be your del XA, again this is del XA is your, this thickness is 0.05, so that will be 0.05 divided by 5 into 3, and this 1 by R3, again this is your 1 by this distance and 1 by this distance, so this will be your XB is your 0.1 and KB is your 10. This is your 0.1, this is your 1, this is your 1.5. So AB is your AB. AB is your AB. So this is 1.5, then perpendicular to the body, the paper is 1. So that is 1.5, and that is 1.5. Okay. So putting the value here. So 1 by R3 is equal to 50 plus 15, solving this, so R3 will be here 0.00606 Kelvin per one, and R4 is delta X B KD AD, so that is 0.05 divided by 50 into 3, that is 3.3 × 10⁻³. Okay, because delta X B is delta X B is 0.05. This thickness is 0.05. Okay. And K is your K is your 50, and area is your 3. And similarly, the convective distance at the other side is 1/2 + E2, and this will be 0.05. So now we can we have taken this as equal R3 as equal distance. So now total distance, all the distances are in series. So total distance is R1 + R2 + R3 + R4 + R5. So R equivalent will be your 0.0434 Kelvin per bar, and Q is equal to T1 - T2 / R equivalent. Or T1 is your 200 and T2 is your 25. So Q comes out as 4.03 2 kilojoules. So answer is 4.03 2 kilojoules. Next, heat flows through a composite slab as shown below. The depth of the slab is 1 meter. The value of K are in watt per meter per degree Kelvin. The overall thermal resistance in Kelvin per watt is option A 17.2, option B 21.9, option C 28.6, option D 39.6. So these are the resistances, and these are the conductivities 0.02 and 0.01, 0.04. This is your 0.5 meter, this is 0.25 meter, this is 1 meter, this is 0.5 meter. So here this is the equivalent figure, and here the resistance is R1, and this is, these resistances are in parallel, so R2 and R3. So assuming it as R equivalent, so R1 will be your delta 1 divided by K1. So delta 1 is your 0.5. And K1 is just 0.02, and this A1 is 1. So that comes out 25. And this R equivalent can be equal to 1 by R equivalent is equal to 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3, or R3 plus R2 by R3, or R equivalent is R2, R3 is equal to R3, R2. And R2 is just 0.5, sorry, that is 0.25 divided by 0.1 into 0.5. So R2 will be your 0.25, 0.1 into 0.5, and similarly R3 will be 0.25 divided by 0.04 by 0.5. So R equivalent comes out as these 0.3. Putting these values, you can get R equivalent as 3.57. So total distance is R1 plus R equivalent. So R1 is 25, and this is your 3.57. So total distance is 28.57 Kelvin per watt. So answer is option C.